must have missed out on their morning coffee this week, as Walmart might have just leaked the sequel to Rage. How, you may ask? By posting a public placeholder on their website. Bethesda's response to the Rage 2 leak is not one you might have expected from a developer who just had their game outed. Walmart and Canada posted a listing on their website for Rage 2, which has not yet been announced. You would think there would be some sort of rage about this leak, but the official Rage Twitter's response was pretty much, "You had one job, Walmart." The grading of their listing is hilarious, but draws attention to one thing: they didn't deny the sequel. Further tweets have been put out by Bethesda, including a rocket ship and an image of Big Ben spray-painted with the same shade of pink that was on the Walmart post. The post indicates a date of 14th of May and a time of 5:15, all very mysterious. Valve announced the release of their new Steam Link app. It will allow you to play any game in your Steam library by streaming it on supported iOS or Android devices. As long as your PC is connected to a good internet connection, either a 5 GHz network or connected via Ethernet cable, you'll be good to go. The next question is, how will you control these games on your device? That has yet to be explained, although Steam's Big Picture mode has already shown controls to be very customizable in games that do not support it. If you wish to use a controller with the app, the Steam controller and MFI controllers will be supported, which will probably be the better option anyway, as most games don't have inbuilt touch controls. The app is set to launch May 21st and will work similarly to the physical Steam Link device. It's not a secret anymore as to which attendees are taking up the most space at E3 2018, as we see the names Bethesda, Bandai Namco, Ubisoft, Activision, and Square Enix amongst the larger floor plans that are taking center stage. After a user on Resetera took the time to cross-reference the booths with corresponding attendees from other major shows such as CES 2018, it's now possible to see who is taking up which spaces for this year's E3. But that's only the South Hall. The West Hall has even larger areas reserved for Sony Interactive and Nintendo, which look to take a good chunk of the floor space. These two developers will be hard to miss this year, with a few names missing from this year's E3, including EA and THQ Nordic, choosing to forego either for their own press event or attending Gamescom and PAX West instead. Bungie shared in a news update via their website that Destiny 2 Season 3 will have the Prismatic Matrix added to the game, allowing a way for players to earn cosmetics through playing the game rather than purchasing with in-game currency. The ability to spend money on Eververse goods is still an option, but this will be a way to allow players to play to earn cosmetics as well. The new system will offer a 10-item rotation, which will be available in the Eververse store. By unlocking one use of the Prismatic Matrix, players will earn a cosmetic with their first well-rested level up of the week. Additional activations of the Prismatic Matrix can be added using 200 silver. The Prismatic Matrix launched with Season 3 and the Warmind expansion earlier this week. The official Nintendo Switch Online service is coming later this year, with the ability to back up data via the cloud service. So now, Nintendo Switch owners won't have to worry about losing their game data when they need to switch over to a new device, lose or break their current device. This new subscription service will be available monthly for $3.99, 3 months for $7.99, and 13 months for $19.99. But that's not all. With the announcement of the subscription service comes some extras that we were not expecting. Nintendo will also offer 20 NES titles as part of the service. Current online gameplay and Nintendo Online app will be free to access until the official launch in September 2018. Focus Home Interactive announced the second episode of the RPG story-driven game, The Council, along with some new screenshots. The episode is titled Hide and Seek. Episode 2 Hide and Seek continues the story of the mysterious tale of the protagonist, Louis de Richer, as he investigates the disappearance of his mother Sarah in the chapter finally confronts Lord Mortimer. The Council Hide and Seek will be available for all to play on May 17th on PS4, Xbox One, and PC, but Complete Season and Season Pass owners will be able to play the second episode in advance on May 15th. Square Enix have announced the date and time for the Square Enix E3 Showcase, a pre-recorded stream that will start at 10 AM PDT on June 11th at this year's E3. What they plan to feature this year has not been revealed, but have teased via Twitter to discuss the exciting future of Square Enix. What are you hoping for Square Enix to reveal this E3? Frostcube Studios have announced they are now allowing players to access the alpha of their game, Rend, a multiplayer faction-based survival RPG game which is available for sign-up via their website. Choose your side in this faction-based survival game, pitting groups of players against each other amid hordes of horrific demons in an ongoing epic war. Explore a mysterious and unforgiving world as you race against the clock to achieve victory before you are wiped from existence. Frostcube Studios are comprised of game developers who have worked on the likes of World of Warcraft, Overwatch, League of Legends, and WildStar. Rend is their first project to be put into production and is now available for alpha sign-up via the Rend website. We finally get a release window for EA's Anthem, an IP action multiplayer RPG, after their original release this year was pushed back to 2019. During a financial conference, Electronic Arts CFO shared the release window for Anthem, which will be making its way to PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One in March of 2019. Executive producer of Dragon Age Mark Dara has been confirmed to joining the Anthem team, also in the same role. Further news this week was shared in a post on the BioWare blog that Anthem will be getting a single-player mode, although originally marketed as a co-op action RPG. Anthem will be showcased at the upcoming EA Play 2018 press event, which will be happening between June 9th and 11th. Well, that's it for the Week in the Wikis. Please join us next week for yet another great week of gaming. Remember to check out our VIP program for some exclusive supporter benefits, and budding writers should take advantage of our Become an Author initiative. Thanks again for being part of this great community. Keep checking in with us for news, reviews, YouTube streams and vids, and general wiki goodness. Follow us on social media for all the latest and greatest. The more followers we get, the larger the army of the Fexes grows.